When light encounters a mirror, it gets reflected. Why? Because the photons, the particles by which light is consisted of, crash with a massive solid, and that causes the direction of the photon's velocity to get opposed, exactly like a basketball bouncing. Why is the sky blue and the sunset red? Because light is a wave, and when the white light from the sun interacts with the atmosphere, the blue light gets scattered way more than red light does. So at noon, the sky is blue because you are seeing all the blue light the person who is watching the sunset doesn't see. At sunset, light passes through so much atmosphere, the possibility of some blue light traveling that far is very small. And if you subtract the blue light from the white light, you get just the orange red. How does the photoelectric effect work? When photons with a specific frequency hit the electrons of an atom, they transfer their energy to them. And if the energy is enough, the electrons can escape the atom. So the material gets positively charged, since some electrons have escaped. Answers like this to questions like this have their purpose, and they serve us good sometimes. But as people start to dig deeper to more and more advanced physics, these answers share the same problem. They make people think that an either-or answer to this question, is light a wave or made out of particles after all, exists. Or, even worse, that we haven't answered it yet. When neither of that is true, let me explain. The correct way to answer this question is, light is the collection of excitations in the photon field. So anything like getting reflected off a mirror, getting scattered from Earth's atmosphere, give energy to an electron, bend when entering water, and so on and so forth, can be explained just by considering light to be excitations in the photon field and behaving according to quantum field theory. Done. It's no mystery anymore. Same goes for the electrons. It's true that some phenomena can be explained by the particle nature and some others by the wave nature, but absolutely all of them can be explained by the excitation in the electron field nature. The roots of quantum field theory have something to do with waves and Newtonian particles, though, as well as special relativity. In classical physics, a particle is something which has no size and it obeys Newton's laws of motion. A wave, on the other hand, in classical physics, diffracts when it passes through a slit, gets reflected when it counters a surface, refracts when it changes the medium it passes through, and it interferes with other waves. Phenomena like the photoelectric effect and the ultraviolet catastrophe could only be explained by considering light to be a stream of particles in the past, and phenomena like interference pattern from a double slit could only be explained by considering light to be a wave. And for this reason, physicists were puzzled about the double nature of light. Also, from 1927 and beyond, thanks to the work of Louis de Broglie, we know that apart from light, electrons and other small particles have a wave-particle-like behavior. Hence the term wave-particle duality was born. This led to the inception of quantum mechanics. Quantum mechanics could explain all of the above phenomena, so it was superior to both light is a particle theory and the light is a wave theory. Quantum mechanics still described light, electrons and everything as particles, but instead of obeying Newton's laws of motion, they obeyed Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, they do not have a specific position and velocity, Pauli's exclusion principle, fermions cannot have the same quantum state, the superposition principle, they could be in multiple positions at the same time, Schrödinger's equation, and others, properties which weren't present for particles with the Newtonian term. in which they had a specific position and velocity, and it was only one. Quantum mechanics did fix many of our problems which were present, but there was one big problem. They did not take into account Einstein's relativity. So we tried fixing that problem, and we partly succeeded. We managed to merge quantum mechanics with special relativity, and that's what we call quantum field theory. Quantum field theory changed the interpretation of fundamental particles to excitations in fields. Very loosely speaking, every fundamental particle has its own field which exists everywhere in the universe but has a zero value, except where a particle would be, where the field has a high value, what we call excitation. Despite our efforts, we didn't and we still haven't merged quantum field theory with general relativity. So when I said quantum field theory can explain everything, well, I meant almost everything. It still lacks features like gravity, due to the incompatibility with general relativity, dark matter, dark energy, matter with antimatter asymmetry, and neutrino oscillations. And this is where today's research is focused on. So keep learning physics, and you may contribute to this task.